Let me explain what he means by that. He means to say that we are the only community that will get outraged and get up and organize and picket in protest to defend the bottom denominator of our community, meaning criminals, burglars, robbers, anything that you commit a crime. Only Black Americans will be out picketing to defend the criminals. It is not something that white Americans do, not something that Jewish Americans do. You will be hard-pressed to find a Jewish American who has a rap sheet as long as the day, and something bad happens to that person, and Jewish people are using their platform to speak out in defense of that person. It won't happen. Same for white Americans. Not a single white American is out there defending Derek Chauvin. They will dispose of the people that they think are, you know, are at the bottom of their society, and they will instead uplift people that are at the top of their society, which means that they're raising their average very easily. You know, when you rally behind the people that are doing the good things in your society, as opposed to people that are doing bad things in society, you raise your average. So we have collectively lowered our average because over the last 5 years, it has become extremely fashionable for us to martyr criminals. It's unbelievable. Not even Latinos do this. They will not martyr their criminals. They do not put the names of their criminals on shirts. They don't buy posters of their criminals. They don't get celebrities to speak out about their criminals, their defense of their criminals. They just say, you are a criminal, goodbye, right? That is just, but Black Americans were unique, and it is incredible because we dismiss people that are at the top of our communities. Bye-bye, Condoleezza Rice, you're a coon. Bye-bye, Larry Elder, you're a coon. Bye-bye, Shelby Steele, Thomas Sowell, coon coons, Uncle Tom's gone, gone. Bye, hate you. Here we are, George Floyd, you are a martyr and a hero. Now, when I first saw the story circulating, everybody wanted to jump on and make him out to be the modern day Martin Luther King. He was just getting his life together. He was out there doing good things. He was making music. Based off the video I saw and the 911 transcript, that just didn't sound accurate to me. But I wanted to let everybody play pretend because it was fashionable and it was trending. I mean, first and foremost, the person who called 911 clearly said that he was on drugs, that something was wrong, but he was not sober. And the person couldn't make out what drug he was on if you read the 911 transcripts. Beyond that, if you look at a video, you will see, which the media has tried to censor, when he's leaning against the wall, when the cop initially pushed George Floyd against the wall, he drops a white baggie of a substance on the ground. I don't know what it is. It could be cocaine. I got